Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Bloodborne. Heading to Bergenworth today, but a couple of things to do first. We're going to change this to that one. And going to pop some. I've got 24 insight, so we'll pop four of the six. I can count. Six of these. And get a chunk. I could probably get some bolt paper too, actually. Five will do for now. I can get that. And I will explain why in just a moment. If I can find where I'm going. Alright, the reason I did these things, first of all, insight. There are enemies in here that cause frenzy, so the higher your insight, the lower your frenzy resist. So I might as well. I mean, there's really no point in having it. Might as well. I've got nothing else to spend it on, I might as well buy a chunk. I'd still rather go chunk farming than than buying it, but never mind. We can't all be chunk winners, can we? Uh-oh. I'm not doing very much damage to these guys. Where is it? The rune. It's the Covenant rune for the Vile Blood. Now I found out, and by found out I mean I saw it on someone else's YouTube video, that there's another gesture I haven't learned, which is actually I'm not exactly sure. I think it was a deep respect or something. I don't think I've got that gesture. You get that from the Vile Blood Covenant by giving up a blood dreg. Now to get a blood dreg, normally you have to have that rune equipped, first of all. And when you've got that rune equipped, you can do it in PvP. I'm not sure if you have to invade or if you can do it if you beat an invader, but either way it's PvP and you'll get a blood dreg. I'm not likely to be engaging in much PvP, I don't expect. I'm probably a bit over level for most PvP, and even if I did, I am terrible at PvP. So there's probably not much chance of me getting a blood dreg that way. However, according to the wiki, you can also get a blood dreg if you kill their NPC hunters while that rune is equipped. So, with a bit of luck, there is an NPC hunter in here who I think I have to kill anyway. I'm not sure if you can sneak past her or not. Probably could be blue elixir. Doesn't really matter that much. I hate these things. And this one starts, this one actually starts with the spells at you as well, this brain sucker, so it can really mess you up. But if I can get this, kill this hunter, get a blood dreg, I will then have to do Kanehurst after all. The only reason to do it is basically for completion. With this character, it'd be kind of cool to get everything. I might not end up getting everything. I might give up, but I'll try. So in that case, yeah, I'd have to do Kanehurst. I'd have to do the Ligarius boss fight, which is a pain in the backside. Not a big fan of that particular fight. Especially if I'm... Oh, shit, I don't know if it was meant to happen. Oh, shit. Wrong way. No. The stairs, run away. Especially if I'm randomizing my weapons and stuff, I'll probably not do too well. Uh-oh. Stuck again. Piss off! Jesus! Look at the aggro range on these guys. It's big, that's what it is. It's only supposed to get one of them at a time. Ow. Oh, oh shit. Shit. Here we go with the frenzy. It's just stopped the meter. I don't like the frenzy mechanic in Bloodborne. Were you just sitting down having a casual relax there? It's like Bleed in other Souls games. Well, not Demon Souls, which was a different bleed. Different damage over time in Demon Souls. But in Dark Souls, it's a meter that builds up the same as that frenzy meter there. And once it fills, it's just an instant loss of health. In Dark Souls, and I think Dark Souls 2, was around about 30%, give or take, most of the time. In Bloodborne here, it's about 80% or something really high. But the reason I don't like it in Bloodborne particularly is because the meter keeps climbing even after the source of the frenzy is gone, which is... I don't like the way they did that. In other Souls games, I don't think there's anything that can do it quite the same way in Dark Souls. It's generally if you get hit by an attack, whereas in Bloodborne there are some frenzies that can happen just by being in proximity to them. But that's not the thing I hate about it. What I hate about it is that even when the source of the frenzy is gone, the meat keep still builds up. And I find that very annoying. It was like that thing when it grabbed me. The meter was only, you know, when the grab finished, the meter was what, a third, halfway, whatever. It kept climbing and almost filled. If I hadn't spent all that insight, it probably would have filled. And that I'm really not that keen on. Now these things here are seriously weird. Giant flower-headed centipede vagina monster thingies. Didn't exactly see it from the front, but very gaping dragon-ish. Not particularly difficult to kill. If you don't get stuck in its legs there. The head is a vulnerable spot on these things, by the way. I'm not doing much damage attacking from the back. If you can hit the head, you can lock onto the flower head so you can shoot it with a cannon or something. And it actually goes down really quickly if you do that. Anyway, the only reason really to do that is to grab these items without sort of being attacked. Alright, that's the bulk of, well, that's the outside of Bergenworth. We've gone all the way around. This is the shortcut back to the lantern. Stuff in here. There's a chest here. I think this did have a spell in it, so it's probably got a... No, it didn't. It had a pearl slug. I think that's a chalice material. All these jars here are actually kind of cool. If you look really carefully, if I can get a good shot of it. Can I... can't really see, but they're full of eyeballs. Gross, yet amusing. This is a kind of useless door. That's just right back to here. You have to go past the main shortcut to open that. It's not even really a shortcut. Anyway, there's that hunter. Now this hunter is a pain in the ass, a real pain in the ass. Oh, and she's seen me. I was hoping you wouldn't. The first time I played through here, she didn't see me and I ended up backstabbing her. Didn't actually do a whole lot of health damage to her and she kicked my ass many times. She's got magic I'm out of trying to anticipate attacks here, but this stuff should work. She does the that's the orb of the brick. Yeah, she does that, which can, yeah, that was only one of them hit me then, and Jesus. Piss off. Can't see. Oh no, 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 no. Get out of it with that. Bloody flame from Rosemarinus, that one is. Uh-oh. Ran out of stamina right at the wrong time. There we go. Do I get a blood drag? Yes, good. Now a blood drag. Is that in this? See, I've never actually got one before because, you know, I suck at PvP and there's another reason. The Vilebloods of Kanehurst, bloodlusting hunters, see these frightful things in cold blood. This is your, spermy blood, whatever. They often appear in the blood of Echo Fiends. That is to say, the blood of hunters. Queen Annalise partakes in these blood drag offerings so that she may one day bear the child of blood, the next vile blood heir. That's Covenant stuff. The Covenant system in Bloodborne is really weak. There are three. It's the runes. There are, let's see, the Hunter, which gives you, I think that gives you a bit of stamina regeneration, that one. That one, does this, there we go, that gives you heal when you're near death, which is pretty much useless, and Vile hit point recovery up gives you more healing, I guess. Not useless, I suppose. It could be moderately useful. Oh, I didn't need to get that, I've already got those. But really, I think the general gist is that nobody much cares about any of the covenants in Bloodborne. Was it student uniform and trousers? Where are they? And there are two different student sets as well, so I'm gonna make sure. They are slightly different stats as well as a different icon, image, whatever. Get rid of that one. Student trousers, they all appear to be the same though. Same image, same text, same stats. Well, it was probably this one. It doesn't really matter, but we'll discard that one. And that just goes to show you, if you discard anything, it's probably gone forever, because I can't pick that up again, unlike in Dark Souls. So make sure you don't drop the wrong thing, is my advice there. I suppose before I could go, I'm pretty sure the key disappears out of my inventory in new game, so there's an enemy up there too, so I just want to be a bit careful. Key, yeah, you've only got the Urden Tome key there. Yep. So I'll have to pick up the Lunarium key, whatever it's called. That one, right there. Lunarium key. More jars of eyeballs. Actually, I don't think I need to go up here. Maybe this is the spell I was thinking of. I'm sure there's an item up here, guard it. Yeah, you. That's what I was looking for. Uh-oh! Jesus, I thought I was going to fall all the way then. That is an OH&S violation right there. No fences at all. Why was I not even attacking at all then? Yeah, a good third of the way up the meter there. What the fuck? Yeah, you fall down the hole. That guy was a bit angrier than the other ones outside. Yes, anyway, if you were paying attention to the frenzy meter, then it got up to about a third-ish and kept going. Even though the source of the frenzy, which was his grab attack, had gone. But yeah, that's a bit of an artifact I don't much like. Now, the empty phantasm shell and went to storage, that's a hunter tool, which is this game's equivalent of spells, I believe. And that one gives you, just adds arcane damage to your weapon. I haven't really found a whole lot of use for most of the spells. I believe they were buffed in a patch, some of them. To be more damaging, the offensive ones, but I've never used them since the patch, and they were really piss weak before then, so. You can give me some insight. He actually points where to go. This is a hidden one. I'm not going to do it right now. And I'm not going to kill him because I've already got the rune that you get for killing him. I'm actually going to... Well, I've got a lot of blood echoes, so I'm going to go and spend them so I don't lose them. I am also going to go back to Yosefka's clinic. And I will tell you why in a moment. A very quick level up. Should be able to get another level out of this. Yep. Sheesh. That's getting really high. No, I'll leave that rune in for the moment. And now back to here. Almost positive I opened the shortcut. Yes, I did. No! Maybe it closes itself. That's weird. I thought I opened that. But, never mind, we can go around. The reason for coming back here, I mentioned when I actually came here earlier that I wasn't going to kill Yosefka. But another thing I discovered, once again by seeing it on someone else's video, is that I'm lost. No, that's not what I discovered. See, in the last playthrough I actually did not kill Yosefka. I waited until after killing Rom and then went and got the umbilical cord from her. Which, of course, is... Damn it, you saw me. Oh, you can parry them. I didn't even know you could do that. Now, obviously, in this one, I don't particularly need to worry about umbilical cords. I'm not going for that ending. I could get them because they're worth insight, but I'd still rather do the farming for chunks than actually farming for insight and buying them. The point being that if you kill Yosefka, she drops a rune, and that's a rune that I don't currently have any level of. So, much as I don't really expect this will go too well, I'm going to give it a go and try and kill her. I believe she's very much like the... See, there's the door. Oh, I'm in the wrong spot anyway. there are multiple levels of runes, but I don't have any of the runes that she drops. Now, I was saying she's like that other NPC hunter that I just killed earlier in this episode. Oh, excuse me, episode. My allergies are starting to play up. It's not even spring yet. I haven't fought her, as I said. I only know this from seeing other people's videos. She casts spells. Apparently she can heal, so that's why I put that numbing mist on.
How'd you worm your way in here? But I won't make any excuse for that. Oh
Yeah, it's just so much easier to come back here afterwards and kill her. You don't even kill her. Well, I guess technically you do, but it's like a one shot. She doesn't even fight back.
This won't hurt a bit.
Don't miss that parry. Ow! Go away! Wow, I am really sucking. Kylie! Ooh, and she causes poison. I didn't notice that. Oh, how come that didn't? Harry. God damn, I am getting my butt whooped. Let me go and put some antidotes on. She's not really... doesn't appear to be any danger of poisoning me, but just in case. Oh. No. I don't know if you can actually parry that, but every time she does it, I keep thinking she's actually going to attack with her. I think she's got a threaded cane. Twin pistol by the looks of things. Or repeater pistol, whatever it's called. I can't actually read what you're saying. I can't hear it at the moment for some reason. It's like it's not actually playing the sound of it. Oh, she healed. You bitch. Hey, I heal again. Hopefully. At least not for a while. Dodge. Oh, I'm stuck on something. Get that regain going. Nope. We don't like that spell, Precious. Right, good. Gotcha. Fake Yusefka, best waifu, of course. When you come back, if you come back after, I think it's after killing Rom. But anyway, if you come back at the other trigger point, well, let's just say, best waifu, certainly. anyway, that is that. And I can probably got time to give Rom a go or two. I don't expect it'll go too well with only a plus six. Saw Cleaver, but we might get lucky. Now, I don't think I got a blood drink out of her either, which was the reason I left. No, I didn't. So obviously she does not count as a hunter. That's fine. That's the reason I left that rune on, but doesn't matter. Okay, we can put that back to stamina recovery, because that's the least bad. I might... Hang on, that one... Physical damage 3%. Arcane damage 7. Rom can do arcane, but his little, or her little minions... I think it's probably much of a muchness. Oops, get rid of that. Change that to bolt paper. Could try putting bulk gems in this, but I don't think I've got any that are good enough. Anyway, I did that before. I was going to say something really important, but I've forgotten what it was. I think it was about that shortcut. with it open, you can just, oh, cheeky. You just run straight through, run past everything. I don't think that guy's ever aggroed on me before when I've just done the run. Holy shit, he's off. Whee! I guess there are two ways you can do this fight, really. First, you can... Oh, you're not aggro on me yet. Well. How much damage you can do, I was going to say before all the spiders come in, but... Actually, that's doing quite a lot of damage. And now you're going to teleport away. Alright, two ways to do this fight, I was saying. You can either kill all these spiders first, which is probably what I'm going to do. It's certainly the safer way. Or you can charge in and... Holy shit! That's what I say about arcane damage. A bit closer. Or you can just charge in and try your luck. Which I think I did the first time and it didn't really work. But if you can get an opening. Oh, that's going away, isn't it? Yes. Can't remember your moves. And these things can hit really hard too. The minions, and there are crap tons of them. The bolt paper's worn off. I am actually really surprised that I'm doing as much damage as I am. Two-shotting these minions. From the side, of course. From the head, though. But you don't normally do that attack when I'm in the middle distance here. Oh, you didn't die. Cheeky. Nah, the problem with Rom is that she teleports more than once, so... What's that attack? Is that the meteor? Yeah. See? Up from the head, that doesn't do much damage. Licks in. Oh, get away, get away, get away, get away! That's the boom. Yo. Oh shit. Didn't see that coming. Went for an attack and shouldn't have. Gotta sort of keep an eye on Rom to see if he can tell what attack she's doing. Yep. I thought that was that one. I didn't know what to call it. The little ground meteor things. It's like Flamestorm from Dark Souls. Is this that same one? Oh, nope, it's not. I didn't see her back end. Not 100% sure on the tells of her moves. Oh, I think she's doing it again. I'm not exactly sure the trigger points for her teleports. She does it three times, so it's probably 75, 50, and 25% health, if I had to guess. All her things are away. Maybe I can give him some chomps. Get away, get away, get away. Well, I did get some hits in. Where are you? There you are. All spiders have come down though, that's the problem. And now she does lots of different attacks too. She can melee attack as well, like that. way. A lot of nasty attacks that can really do damage, so... just, top yourself up. Oh, shit! Those pricks do more damage than she does! I might need to clear more of them out. It's a ground one. It's a pity there's no... she doesn't do friendly fire. No, they're not giving me any openings. Oh, that's a meteor storm. You. Ground thingy. Bait that ground attack thing, it's not too bad. Can, oh! Wrong one. I'm not supposed to do that one. I can get in some attacks on these things. That actually looked like the same tail as the other attack. Okay, now I'm confusing myself with what attacks she does. Oh shit, get away. Get away. Run. I don't think these mini spiders can one-shot me, but they can definitely stun lock. If more of them than one attack at once. They can definitely stuff me up. Whatever. Run. Damn it. Okay. Okay, so if your head and your ass is in the air, you appear to be doing that ground storm. If it's just the head, I think you do the sky storm. And if I'm in close, you can do either the explosion or the AoE, or now you've got melee attacks as well. I've got an itchy nose, and it's a really bad time to get an itchy nose. I saw her move, and I knew it was coming, but I couldn't stop myself from taking that second swing. Run! Now I've heard, but haven't seen it myself, that you can stun lock ROM. Shit. With a, I think, a flamethrower. Ooh, I think if you Shaman Boneblade. And get all these spies to kill each other. Now that would be fun. In fact, that would be hilarious. Is left. I'm sure the range is when she, the AI triggers for each attack. Because obviously the one where they come from the sky is very long range. I mean, you can do that right from the end of the arena. That one where she sort of rolls over and jumps a bit, that's only like point blank. Well, not point blank, but close range. Right. Okay. Now, you shit. Trigger. Whatever that was. That explosion. Oh, jump. Oh, caught me right on the end of it. Just fill up just in case. Die. I think it said 28? That was a lot. A lot of people have died here. I'm not really surprised. Ron seems to be a fairly polar... In fact, I think a lot of the bosses in this game are polarized. People seem to either think, oh, it's piss easy, or, God, that's so unfairly hard. I didn't actually... I forgot that you had to... I thought you had to actually talk to her. Anyway... Cutscene. Skip cutscene. Skip loading screen. Look. Unpleasant. You don't need 40 insight to see them anymore. I haven't been here yet in this particular playthrough. Back up there, at that door, is Cathedral Ward. Can head back. But we're going to head forwards. That door better be open because this guy's going to do unpleasant things. So if you do that, I've got the tonsil stone, so you can let him grab you and him, her, or it, and get transported to lecture hall, something like that. I'm not sure if these guys count as beasts. They might, because I seem to be doing decent damage to them with the saw cleaver. But anyway, that will end up having to do me once I get to the next lantern, which is not far. I don't need to worry about continuing on too far. There it is. Right, I'll just pop back to the dream. Now I'm going to need another 10,000 echoes. Actually, before I do that, I'll just do some repairs, just to make sure. I think I can still do it with 10,000. That will be a level 11 cold blood. Do I have a level 11 cold blood? I think that's enough.
Welcome home. What is it? Very well, let me.
Yep. Do that. 199 echoes left. Alright.
Hello, good huntsman.
Yeah, that's going to do it for this episode. I don't need to use the tonsil stone to get to the lecture hall because I'll get through it after the next boss anyway. If I recall where it is I'm going, and I think I do. I should also start getting chunks soon. There are chunks in this area I'm up to, so with a bit of luck I'll be able to start upgrading some more weapons. So I guess thanks very much for watching, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye bye.